Away from that, for decades, farmers in Bugaya County have depended on hand hoe for agriculture which has greatly affected their production levels. Bugaya County is known for its production of coffee, maize and rice, but the output has been on a small scale and majority on subsistence agriculture due to lack of merchandise mode of farming.
Swaib Nyanga Biachi, the speaker, Hoima District Local Council 5, says as a district they have been grappling with the challenge of inadequate tractor services because the entire district has been relying on only two tractors donated by the president to women and the youth.
This facility has come so timely because as Hoima District local government, we thought of the same and procured two tractors, one for the youth and the other one for the women. So we want to thank Honorable Pius Wakabi for this initiative because it has added on what we have as Hoima District local government.
Farmer, we have had the problems of machines, especially when it comes to plowing season. Machines are very few. We have been having very few machines or tractors to plow our grounds. But now we have two more, which means our work is going to be easier. Plow, we have the narrow there, they have a few tractors, we have individuals with a few tractors.
The women and people with disabilities say that it has been a tug of war accessing a tractor because of the high competition for the two tractors whose management has not been clear. The Muhinga Sub-County District Councillor says that women make up the biggest percentage in agriculture but have not been helped to develop.
Tractors are going to help us in empowering women to dig because most of our women in Hoima are farmers. We really dig, we have maize, we have vegetables, we have fruits. We think we want to talk with our MOP so that he can reduce on the price of hiring these tractors. Either we can buy fuel for our women, then it also...
People are doing, they are economically doing bad. So I've brought these tractors to empower my people so that they can move from subsistence farming to at least somehow commercial farming. And I'm also supporting Museveni's program of not working for the way he says it, a kid that you own, but he also works for some money for fees and other things.
Wachibi says that he will organize the youth and women to form groups so that they can hire idle land to start meaningful production. He says that the farmers will not directly benefit from the oil but can make money through selling the agriculture produce to the oil sector.
If we have our tractors and I organize my people into circles, into cooperatives, because now I'm going to form cooperatives for in my constituency. I'm going to zone my constituency, like Kyabigambire, they are coffee farmers. I want to form a coffee cooperative for Kyabigambire. When you go to Kitoba, they are cocoa farmers. I've already mobilized them into a cooperative and I'm even supporting them. When I go to Seruka, they are fishermen. If you can form fishing cooperative for that place, it will be a better idea.
In Uganda, at least 68% of the population is still outside the cash economy, and commercialization of agriculture is one of the means to bridge this gap. The farmers will pay 60,000 shillings for plowing an acre of land instead of the prevailing market prices of 120,000 shillings per acre. Using the hand hoe, a farmer would spend more than 2 weeks to plow an acre, yet a tractor takes just a few minutes to do the same work, hence helping the farmers catch up on time. Hoima District is now strategizing on how to help tobacco farmers have a fallback position in case tobacco companies fail to buy their produce. Story by Ismail Kasioha for the news.